Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be drawing Pikachu yet again, but he's going to be dressed up as a Zubat. Let's get going. Well, it's been a while, guys, but welcome back. I am drawing super fast right now. That's because I'm sketching with my double-sided colored pencil. So you guys know this. If you guys are familiar with the channel, if you're new, aka it's been a while. So if you guys look for this in the silly scene, my last video was about 5 months ago, and I apologize for that. It won't happen again. I think the majority of things that are really interesting right now are basically over with, so I'm ready and set to do more YouTube videos. So anyways, I'm drawing Pikachu right now. I'm painting his head, and I did a little top hat for him. And he's going to have kind of like a jumping pose, and he's trying to spread out his little Zubat wings. So over here, drawing his little feet. He's kind of like I don't know how to describe it. Peanut type of foot. That's what his type of foot is. But anyways, going ahead and doing some collars for him. A nice big brooch. Be shaped as a Zubat mouth. That looks like Golbat actually, but no. Same thing, it's just an evolved version. But anyways, his hand's gonna be up on this side. He's gonna have cute little gloves. So I'm gonna outline that right now so you guys can see. Just like that. Has four little fingers and a tiny fourth thumb. No, doesn't look perfect. And then his large wings. Here we go. And I'm gonna curve them outwards, just like so. So now we got the basic sketch of it. We start doing some more detail. I'm pressing a little bit harder with our colored pencil, so we can find what's going on. You can see that I want to do kind of like a mini face, because so what we're going to do is we're going to make sure his mouth is open, and put some fangs on him. And I'm going to have eyes pointing down. So we're going to spot the highlight on both eyes, and there we go. So let's go back with a black marker, and let's trace everything. So here are these eyes I was talking about. Fill them in. We use some white spots for the highlights. Those highlights also emphasize how cute he is. I'm trying to look at what I'm going to do first. I'm going to try to clean up some of these lines first before I head on to the top. And then I'll get confused later. There we are. Here we go, bottom part. Alright. Now to this side. And the arms. There we go. I'll start doing gloves on this side. Move on to the other side. I'm gonna just divide that because I think I'm gonna change colors. There we are. I did a curved line to show it's not so flat. It's more of a three-dimensional glove. Okay, don't care about his cheeks, those signature cheeks. I didn't have to outline the cheeks if I didn't want to, but I did it anyways. Those sharp teeth. For the costume army, of course. Tongue. While I'm at it, I'll still fill that part in. Okay, here comes the ears. There we go. While I'm at it, I might as well fill in this part in black. Because I'm already here. There. On the other side now. There we go. His ears are all done. I'm just going to fill this top edge in. Moving on to the top hat. The top hat has a little Pokeball on it. You guys didn't see that coming. Here we are. Got a nice curved top. Put some lines to the inside to emphasize that there's a band around it. There we are. Right here comes the Zubat head in the middle. Like a middle decoration. Some teeth. Bottom set of teeth. There. Must be coloring that little section right there. There. Okay, pick up the cape. Let's fill that in. Alright. Do the other side, the glove, before I go into the other side of the cape. And no, I didn't do the other collar. still got this half a cape, the tail, and the arms in the back. But we'll get there. Go. Here comes the tail. His signature tail. I'll end on that a little bit because it's brown. Then the back. And there we go. So let's get the color. So we speed it up a lot because this part you guys should know already. So the cheeks are going to be bright red. Okay, and then I'm going to move on to the rest of the colors. We might as well do the tongue. Then that, getting ready for the yellow. And here we go. So this is kind of honeycomb yellow. I know it looks dark right now, but as you guys always know, it is ink, so it will dry differently than what you think. So be cautious of that whenever you guys use marker. You always want to check, especially when it comes to premium markers like this, not the normal Crayola markers. You can't really trust the cap too much. You want to make sure you test it on a bunch of paper and then let it dry for a good, I don't know, 20 seconds to see the actual true color it's going to turn out to be. Because you can see, it's been approximately maybe like a couple seconds, and you see that top here where I started, it started to get a little bit brighter. But from coloring, it's a little bit of a darker yellow. That's because it's freshly put on. So, these premium markers are alcohol based, so you want to make sure you guys are careful with that. If you guys decide to use these type of markers, you want to make sure you don't stain anything. Try purple markers. There you go, the tail, and that will dry lighter. You can see the face is already brightening up a little bit. I only used three colors, but let me just finish this Pokeball up there. Alright, I have a blue, purple, and an indigo. I'm going to start by selecting some pretty smart places to put them. So turn off the blue. Okay. Some collar, to the top hat, the gloves, top hat for wings. So, I think that's going to go with the blue. Move on with the indigo. Like the other purple I just put down, but when it dries, this is Zubat 2. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I can't wait to do more. I'm glad I'm back. And if you guys want to see more videos, here's some other ones I've done in the past. And as always, see you guys next time. Have a good one.